Hi, this is Elle from ElleWillPepper.com. As you know, I'm into urbanized growing, and one thing that's difficult when you're in an urban setting, typically what that means is you have a small amount of land to work with, maybe not much of any land to work with. Some people have to grow things on patios, walkways, balconies, decks, sidewalks. So it can be a challenge to do things that a more conventional gardener that maybe has an acre or two or even more of land is able to do. And certainly composting has always been a challenge. I'm on a very small lot and often envious of those people that have room to just put together a big pile, stack up a bunch of discarded lawn waste and other types of vegetable-based matter that can just sit and be turned and give them nice, beautiful, friable compost. It's something that you really find is a challenge when you don't have space for such a large pile. Certainly, when you're talking about doing hot composting, how are you going to be able to get such high temperatures when you just don't have that much mass? And I recently acquired a really nice compost thermometer, but just to drive the point home, I just want to share with you a little note that this says. It talks about different zones of temperature ranges that you can reach with composting, the steady zone, the active zone, and then note what it says for the hot zone. Congratulations, you are the envy of backyard composters everywhere. Now, what's the hot zone? It says that this is 130 to 160 degrees Fahrenheit. And note what else it says. Only large piles, 4 feet by 4 feet and larger, can obtain such high temperatures with nitrogen-rich materials such as grass clippings. Wow, you know, talk about taking the wind out of your sails if you're not really in a position to have a 4-foot by 4-foot pile. Well, people have been aware of tumbler composters for a long time, and I've heard some negative feedback from those. People from a community garden that I'm a member of, many of them are not supportive of tumbling units. Why is that? Is it faulty construction? Is there something about the way that those things are working that these people aren't satisfied with the results, so they steer people away from it? Well, maybe so. But what I insist is that not all tumbling composting units are made the same. And through some research, I found this unit that is just a few inches away from me here that is a lot different from many of the other offerings out there. And I want to show you some of the highlights about this unit. This is a Jora composting unit, and this particular model is the JK270. So I just recently purchased this myself. I've been using it. Now let's see why this is a good solution, especially for someone that is in more of an urban setting, has very limited space, and other circumstances that make it so they can't do as much as someone that has several acres to work with. So here we are looking at the JK Jora composter, and this is a tumbling unit. The model is JK270. To me, that seems to be the sweet spot of sizes that are offered for these models. There is a smaller size, there is a larger capacity unit, but this one seems pretty good, and I've been using it for a few weeks now, and I can say I am happy about the size that I purchased. In regards to the construction, this is a remarkably sturdy unit. I've seen a lot of plastic-based models out there, and it's just no comparison. The way that this is put together, very, very sturdy. There's this metal here that is coated. It's a galvanized metal, and you have actual screws screwing this all together. We have side vents here for good aeration. There are two of those that you're supposed to keep free. And even the support that it's on is very sturdy. I haven't had any issues thus far. And when it comes to actually spinning the unit, it spins very nicely, very freely. This actually has two separated chambers. One you can begin to fill up and keep putting things in it, keep putting things in it. Once it's full, you let it go and you let it to continue to compost and finalize in the breakdown process, and then move over to this other chamber and start putting fresh scraps in here. I haven't even begun to use the second chamber yet, but you can see there are some very nice secure locking mechanisms here that
you can lift open, and what's this? Right away you see that this has a foam insulation. This foam insulation is one of the keys to the success of this unit. The reason is, even though your pile isn't as large as, say, one of those 4-foot by 4-foot piles, there is enough volume that with insulation, the heat that's generated by the bacteria is trapped inside this chamber, and then it begins to rise, and you get a very nice breakdown of weeds, of diseases, different pathogens. They're destroyed through the process of a nice thermophilic compost. And, well, does this really get that hot, though? Let's look at this chamber, where I have currently a nice hot reaction going on, and see how hot it really is. For several weeks now, I've been putting material in here, and whoa, you can see all this steam coming out. This is pretty crazy. Let's look. What do we have here? I don't know if you're able to see this, but we're very close to 150 degrees. Looks like 148 right now. That is hot. All those bad things, they're all going to be broken down, especially with adequate moisture levels and enough time at this high temperature. That's going to do everything that you need a compost cycle to do. This inexpensive compost thermometer is just such a great tool. I got this off of Amazon.com, and it gives you the ability to be able to gauge where you are. You can see here it has a standby, an active, and then a hot section to let you know, okay, do I want to put in more greens? Do I want to put in more browns? Or just let it set for a while and not put anything in and let it work. You can get a good idea of where you are, and it helps you to gauge, you know, your nitrogen and carbon ratios. But let's look at how hard or how easy it is to spin this, because you need to do it every day. I usually do it a couple times a day, so let's check that out. When I spin it, of course, I take out the thermometer. You don't want that puncturing the insulation, getting all buried in there. But other than when I'm spinning it, I've been leaving this thermometer in there all the time so that I can just open it up, get a gauge on the temperature. But we have these nice sturdy handles here, and you can just start going like that. It's that easy. And there's a lot of mass in here. This is pretty close on this chamber to being filled to the top. I put in buckets and buckets of organic waste in here. And very smooth action as far as spinning. Doesn't look like it wants to flop over. I don't have to really strain myself to do this. I really don't see why anybody would not want to use a unit like this. As you can see, a lot of these panels are nice and clean. You do have some dripping that goes on, and I have not yet wiped this for the last 3 weeks or so that I've been using it. I haven't done anything, so this is the dirtiest that it's gotten so far. I do have underneath on the floor some lids that are turned upside down to catch drippings, that way I don't have them going onto the concrete. But other than that, this has been a really clean way to be able to do some composting, and I'm doing it indoors. So there's something to be said for that, to get a reaction that, as you saw, is close to 150 degrees without a 4-foot by 4-foot pile. Doing that indoors, you could do it in a garage, you could do it in a basement if you want. That's up to you. You could give it a shot. But of course, this is made and intended to be able to be used outdoors as well, so there's no problem with doing that. This has been one of the best investments that I made, and it's worth every penny that I paid for it. I ordered it from a seller off of Amazon and had no problems putting it together. It took a little bit of time, but it really wasn't that bad. I had a couple pieces that were missing as far as like a couple screws. Contacted the seller, they immediately got back to me and sent me replacement screws so I could have the whole thing up and running, and I'm just really happy with the results. I don't want to try any other way, besides my vermicomposting, of course, using the worms, which is great. But besides that, any type of hot composting, this is how I want to do it. It's just so painless. You know, you're not like digging into like a really big pile and really straining yourself trying to flip this all the time. Come in here, just kind of go like this. I mean, how hard is that? you know, and you can tuck this in an area where it's out of the way. I mean, yeah, you need to be able to access it, but it doesn't have to take up your whole yard. So I definitely recommend this unit. If you're thinking about any type of a tumbling unit, maybe one of those ones that rock back and forth, don't get something that is some flimsy, plastic, uninsulated tumbler. You want something that is well constructed, something that's insulated. That way you can get high temperatures and you can really find success with your endeavors. You don't have this thing that's falling apart on you after maybe using it for a month or two. I can tell that this is something that's going to hold up for years, and it's so effortless compared to many other ways of trying to get a hot compost process. So I hope that this video was able to help you and to be able to see the things that you need to assess if you want to get into this. Oh, and don't forget to subscribe, because I'm sure I'm going to do some follow-up videos on this, on the finished compost when I take it out, and you're going to want to see how it worked out. So make sure you subscribe, give me a thumbs up, and once again, thanks for watching this video.